I think we can envisage a time where cancer is turned into a chronic disease.
It may happen, but it can be caught early and removed.
And all of these treatments will be tailored to the patient's personal preferences, their demographics, their background.
So we should use technology and innovation to better understand the spiritual and emotional aspects of humanity.
I believe Europe, as it currently stands, is the very best place to start a biotech company or to invest into one.
Improvements in diagnostics are revolutionizing healthcare because they enable us to detect diseases much earlier. This progress is contributing to people living longer and healthier lives. As these innovations advance, diseases will be diagnosed with greater accuracy, improving outcomes for patients. This will significantly impact how healthcare is managed and funded in the future. I'm Annabelle Murphy, a journalist partnering with Fujifilm to bring you the Toward Tomorrow interview series. We've spoken with experts across Europe, doctors, researchers, and entrepreneurs to explore how cutting-edge diagnostic technologies are reshaping healthcare and enhancing patient outcomes. Let's start with a major disease of our time, cancer.
People are living older nowadays, and this means that over the course of lifetime, between one in two or one in three people get cancer in their lifetimes. And therefore, it is one of the major health issues and one that we're making good progress year by year.
Lung cancer is the most common cause of cancer death in the UK, Europe and worldwide. It was responsible for more deaths of women than breast cancer, and in men it kills more men, unfortunately, than prostate and colorectal cancer combined. So it really is a massive public health problem in Europe. So the main key issue with lung cancer is what we term late diagnosis. So we see patients with advanced disease. However, if we can promote early diagnosis, where we're seeing patients at an earlier stage, then outcomes would be far better.
So we know that catching cancer early can really boost survival rates. But can this technology be applied to other diseases as well?
There's two ways that you can pick up cancer. The first one is take the blood and work out if you've been born with some abnormalities there, which means you're more likely to get cancer. But the other type is also take that blood test out, sequence it and work out if you look inside the blood, is there floating DNA from cancer? If you see there's floating remnants of cancer there, then you know that actually this person needs to be checked out. It's now time for a cancer check. The progress has been made through new tests to pick up cancer at a much earlier stage, and also new therapies which are coming online. So, and actually we've mentioned mRNA therapy, that's a very, very big one. Immune therapy is also happening too. You've also got cell therapies and genetic therapies where actually you can go in and modify and fix the genetic problems which cause disease. So these are all developing very, very quickly.
So the early diagnosis of lung cancer is a really exciting area because there are a number of really key innovations that are occurring over the next few years, and I think will translate into changes in clinical practice in the next 5 years. So the first really important thing is the implementation of low-dose CT scanning. So we know from big trials carried out in Europe and the US that screening people with a low-dose CT scan who are at high risk of lung cancer has the potential to reduce deaths, reduce mortality and save lives from lung cancer. So it's really important that at a starting point, we implement low-dose CT screening for high-risk individuals across Europe.
These advancements in early cancer detection are really promising and exciting, but they need a strong healthcare system to really make an impact and even a rethink of how the system works altogether.
I believe Europe, as it currently stands, is the very best place to start a biotech company or to invest into one. there's so many things that could be done to support the evolution of a revolutionary healthcare ecosystem in Europe. Three C's. Firstly, a cult culture. We need to make sure that we are providing as much support to successful site entrepreneurs to bring back the expertise, talent, and capital back into the ecosystem. And then it comes to the second C, capital. We need to, especially the government, needs to unlock as much capital to be able to leverage private commitments from other investors to provide as much support and funding to healthcare sort of side entrepreneurs. And the third is corporate. We need to send a very clear message as a European ecosystem to corporates from all over the world that we are open for business. Corporates should come and shop around and be able to invest and support our startups. Fulfilling those three C's will eventually help us building a virtuous cycle to scale up innovation in European healthcare scene.
We are not a long way off because the healthcare system is always iterating, always find the most efficient ways of doing things and also bring in new practices. We've seen how you can quickly reconfigure a hospital within months. And actually, if that change continues, then actually healthcare can be much, much leaner and more efficient than before, designed around the patients, around their needs, or in a way that works with doctors and also the healthcare system to bring down costs and make it very efficient. So I'm much more confident than you are that actually the healthcare system will continue to improve because we've seen it. We've seen it in recent years, it can change completely, and that change when it continues will mean that actually it's easier than ever to address healthcare problems going ahead.
So we've looked at the potential of these new diagnostic tools as well as what European healthcare systems would need to do in order to be able to bring them into life and scale them to reach more people. So with this in mind, what could this look like? What could healthcare look like for someone who may experience cancer in the future?
I think we can envisage a time where cancer is turned into a chronic disease. I'm hoping that we will have ways to prevent cancer developing, but in those that do develop cancer, we will have treatments, if not to cure, but then to control cancer for a very long time so that that patient can maintain a good quality of life for as long as possible.
In the future, it might be that if it works for one cancer, you can port that information so it's likely to work for other cancer too. Or you can design new trials like umbrella trials, which will allow multiple cancers to go simultaneously through one engine. If that happens, the time to speed up cancer therapy development will be very, very quickly, and the cancer vaccines could come up much quicker than we expected.
So we've talked about the power of these diagnostic tools within a doctor's surgery or hospital. But let's take it one step further. Can this technology help us to manage our own health and spot any diseases even before we get to a doctor's surgery?
So two amazing bits of technology are coming together. Number one, sequencing. You can sequence a human genome, you can sequence a cancer, but what that enables you to tell is what is abnormal in that cancer and what can you target. And we've also got vaccines coming through now, being able to update vaccines very quickly. So you put both of them together, I know what's abnormal in a cancer and I can make a vaccine against it. That's where the magic will potentially come out. And that's what's being tested through personalized cancer approaches and personalized cancer therapies.
Medicine is becoming more and more personalized and specialized, which is a great thing because this is what innovation is bringing in medicine and in healthcare. The capacity of developing advanced therapies and very specialized, personalized ways of treating complex diseases, diagnosing and treating complex diseases. But one aspect which we often forget, and this is probably at the root of what being a clinician is to treat patients and their families in a much more holistic way, rather than just focusing with a microscope literally on the disease and the problem, which is also needed, so that highly specialized scientific intervention is needed, but remembering also the complexity of the human being and understanding the social and the psychological impact of a disease, and then how these impact also the siblings, the families, and the surrounding community.
So can these diagnostic tools help us understand our own health when we're out in the community living day-to-day lives?
Technology also can help and assist in understanding our human touch even deeper. We can use biohackers and wearables to understand and decode our emotions.
Clinical trials will be able to leverage wearable sensors that patients are just wearing in the community to understand how the treatment is impacting the patient outcomes in the real-world setting, as opposed to just a controlled task in the hospital. So we can leverage that to really understand how the treatment is impacting the patient in terms of their everyday life. Could be an AI assistant that they feel is a friend to them and is supporting them on their care journey, helping to prompt them on what kind of different behavioral interventions they should be doing, how they should be eating better, when they should be taking their medication, when there might be a signal in one of the vital signs that their wearable is tracking, that they might need to go into hospital and see a doctor in person. The impact that that has on clinical trials is that you're able to reduce that 90% failure rate and provide more precise measures of disease progression, shorten the trials, reduce the cost of the trials, allowing more therapeutics to come to market. And I think just having that certainty of knowing where you stand in terms of your healthcare in the community, I think will give people a lot of confidence and feel very empowered about their own care.
We've talked a lot today about the advancements in therapeutics, both within a hospital environment and within the community, and the impact that's going to have on disease management and even cure. So we thought it was interesting to ask our experts, what's their vision for what healthcare might look like in the future? How will science, emotion, and technology all come together to produce a great outcome?
So all these advances in the technology will benefit communities too. And there's a number of reasons why this to be the case. Firstly, everyone will live healthier lives, working longer, being able to meet family, to see friends, and we can take that fear of disease away from everyone. Secondly, it could save healthcare systems money. And third one, I think it generally is good because it allows a nation to reach its maximum potential. If you've not got so many people unwell, so many people with disease, then actually we can all focus on what matters, which is to make the world a much better place and improve the health around the world too.
I imagine a lot of care that does not need to be delivered in the hospital will be managed from home. There'll be a lot more remote assessments, so you'll have automated AI assistants that will help you to do the history taking, create a correct diagnosis. You'll have automatically your prescription sent to the door of your house. If you need to see a doctor, I think there will still be a lot of human touch element to it. For certain conditions, you need to do, for instance, an examination. But I really believe a lot of the care, and specifically preventative care, of chronic conditions will not need to be managed within the hospital context. So I feel like we're at a crucial turning point at the moment. We have these immense pressures on the health systems. We need to start implementing and unlocking these new technologies to really support the health systems going forward.
And what that means is shifting from disease care to healthcare. I envisage a future where we collectively, as investors, academics, entrepreneurs, government officials, policymakers, will shift away from disease care to healthcare. Because as it currently stands, what we do is that we intervene too late into the process. But in the very near future, we will be aging backwards. We will be able to diagnose diseases significantly earlier, and we will have far better capacity at treating them as well.
We are so focused on the disease that we are forgetting the emotional aspects that as humans we live when going through a difficult journey like a disease. And this should be part of the healthcare, embracing the emotional landscape and the complexity of facing with a life-limiting condition should be taken into consideration at the same level as developing new technology for treatment and diagnosis of these complex diseases. So we should use technology and innovation to better understand the spiritual and emotional aspects of humanity.
Looking ahead, the future of diagnostics is truly exciting. With the right strategies and strong collaboration, we have a great chance to build healthcare systems that not only improve outcomes and extend lives, but also better meet everyone's needs. It's all about making healthcare more efficient, smarter, and personalized, paving the way for a healthier and more hopeful tomorrow.